that's a good thing with the 4MATIC system is that it's really good. It's still really drivable, you know, that's why you get it. But it's just really good. It's almost, it really just feels like, to me, like the rain is just not there. Mercedes did a good job of knocking the rain off. I can see clearly now that the rain is gone. What's up, YouTube? Oh, wait. I always wanted to get this out. I don't know why people always say, what's up, YouTube? It ain't really YouTube. It's just the people watching YouTube. But, I mean, I do get it, though. But let's do the regular intro. Hey, what's up, Star Status? It's 3D the Rap Star, a.k.a. It's the Benz Man. Welcome back to the channel. And if you are new, please hit that subscribe button.
Please.
Please. Why? Because I'm in the S Coupe once again doing another video. So I don't really think I told people why I really got this car, why I really wanted this car. I think my main subs or my main core subs know why. But to all the new people reeling in, like, what is this with this S Coupe? Why is always on this channel? Make sure you follow me on my Instagram. And it's the Benz Man. It's ITSTHEBENZMAN. And y'all know it's that hard work and dedication today. It's dedication today. Why? Because it's raining. Look at this. So I'm bringing this video for y'all in the rain. You know, a lot of cars or a lot of people do not know how to drive, you know, when it's raining. I don't even want to say don't know how to drive. They don't know the road conditions. You got to assess the road. You got to read the room. All right, let's just get right into today's video. So, you see these windows?
Look at that profile.
It's no B-pillar. I don't care how hard it's raining. I don't care. We gonna show the windows. That's number one. Look at that seatbelt comes to you. It's raining, but look at that view. The number one reason why I even started and thought about getting this car was for them pillarless windows. Just look at that view. So that's really number one. There's only really three cars on the market that do that. I touched on it on the last video, was the Bentley GT and the E-Class Coupe. All the other ones got the little bar right there. But I touched on that on my latest video, but that alone sold me the car, and that's coming from a CL owner first. So the CL owner first, and then you just had to move on. You had to step up. You had to go to the next thing going, which was this thing. So I don't care if it get all wet in here, all rainy in here. This just materialistic, just a materialistic car. That's how I was able to get over my CL so easy. People thought, oh, you was gonna stay on it. Oh, nothing like as bad as it's just a car. There's nothing more important really than family. Remember that, family and people that love you. And that's the main part of it. All this is just material. This car could go next week and I could go get another Benz just like it, or an S63 or whatever. Okay, we talked about them windows. That's really my favorite thing coming from a CL. So when I first got into Benz's period, it was a CLS. I didn't even know what a CL was until I went to the lot. I couldn't get the CLS at the time. And then I waited a year and I saved money and I seen another Benz rolling around. I'm like, what is that? It's just bigger. It's bulkier. It has more presence to it. So that's when I seen the CL, and then I got that. And then just upgraded to this for those of people that don't know. But my next favorite feature is this 360 camera that pops out. What? This was a 2014 model it came out. Well, as a 2015 model car. But just that alone is nice. I just like the way it look. Like how they didn't cheap out and try to put the camera down here or something. It actually comes off the body of the car. I just think that's like one of the real like gorgeous features they could do. So when you step back and you could just look and be like, what is that? Like, why is that thing out? Like, what is it? But it's a full 360 camera. It's not just a reverse camera. It's a full 360 camera that gives you angles around the whole car while also giving you a 180 view. Camera looks, you know, the resolution is pretty good. So that's crazy because it just gives you like a bird's eye view of the whole camera. I mean, it was just a nice feature to have at that time. I mean, the standard modern cars don't even have that yet. Well, most of them, you know, the economy and all those cars start getting some of the stuff later on. All All right, so the next thing I want to talk about is this 4MATIC system. You know, it's a perfect time for it. You know, it says this sometimes because of the car wrap. So it's saying radar sensors dirty. See operator's manual. I don't have no operator's manual. That's besides the point. So it's as it's raining out, this is a perfect time to show it and show what it could do. You know, it's really good in the rain. There's like no slip, no tire loss. So if we hit the corner, we give it some gas. You know, it's pretty good. It's pretty fast. You know, I drove it to San Francisco one time. I took my uncle to the airport out there and was good. The car did not scare me, not one bit. It just did not scare me one bit. You know, it was really great. It did really good. You know, like it takes the corner. You can even give it some gas cornering. You know, you can give it some gas cornering. It's really good in the rain. You know, it looks good. It feels good. You know, in the rain, it doesn't really even feel like it's raining. So that's a good thing with the 4MATIC system is that it's really good. It's still really drivable. You know, that's why you get it. You know, the 4MATIC really just a fancy way to say, or Mercedes way to say, four-wheel drive, all-wheel drive, take it how you want to take it. It may be slight differences, but it all mean the same. It's like twin turbo, bi-turbo. To Mercedes is bi-turbo, but in America we say twin turbo, but it's the same thing essentially. Even if you go on Wikipedia under bi-turbo, it's classified under twin turbo as well. So it's either or. But just look, as you see how it's raining and like giving it some gas. That's why I said it's plenty power, it's plenty quick. I can't even get the word plenty out. That's how you know it's doing its job. But it's just really good. It really just feels like to me like the rain is just not there. Mercedes did a good job of knocking the rain off. I can see clearly now that the rain is gone. And so I'm not even gonna touch into all these functions. I showed this on another video with everything the car could do. It can give you an active massage, you know, shoulders, dynamic contour. Okay, so why is this my favorite over other ones? Oh, so you don't got the money for an SLS. So how is this your favorite one? Like, this was the dream car to me next to the CL. And even if I could get an SLS, yeah, I'll have one in the stable. You know, the one where the doors go up and everything. But I wouldn't take it over this car. This is a comfortable car. It blends what you want in a car so well. It is an S-Class. The S-Class is the best Mercedes in terms of the new tech and just everything new that it has to offer at the time when the car comes out. And it does its job well. I couldn't complain. The only thing you could do after a year, say, of getting this car is maybe getting the AMG one. But for me, you know, I never needed it. It wasn't a must-have, but, you know, all my bros now, I feel like they all got AMGs. It might be time to get an AMG, but I just feel like, you know, I don't go to the track and I don't race. So, and feeling how this one feel, you know, I think the MCT or whatever the transmission is called on the AMG, you know, give you a little jerkier shifts. I just like that smooth butter feel. Like this car, when it's moving, it feel like it's not moving. It's like hard to explain. So that's why I would really take this over, like, you know, a SLS. If all these cars the same price, I'm picking this car again. It gotta be my first love. It's the first car I would get, the CL slash the S Coupe. And then, okay, let's get an AMG GT. Or then, okay, let's get an SLS. But as first car, as first dream car, it gotta be this one. It just has to be for me. That's why I said for me, you know, we're all different. We all like different stuff. I might be that crazy one that actually like the, as they say, the regular Mercedes over the AMG. I don't race and I don't really hit the track. So why get it? That's just me, of course. I'm probably like, if you put 1,000 people in the line, I'm probably the only one that's going to look at the S550 and be like, hey, hand me that one. That's all I need right there. That's me. I just look at the car and see me. I don't need the over the top car. I'm not trying to show off. Rub it in nobody's face, nothing. We all the same. We all could get any car if you put your mind to it. So it's not really about that. But the AMG, to everybody that get them, they're not trying to show off. It is the better buy. But if you want more of the luxury side, more of the comfortable side, you would get this car. And that's why I titled it that. I don't think I ever really told my subs truly why I would really want this car or like this car. We talked about the CL, but this is basically an updated CL with better tech, better everything. The bi-turbos get moving quickly. That makes the car actually feel somewhat like an AMG. Then bi-turbos give you that extra kick that the CL550 didn't have. And the CL550 was fast, but it didn't have that extra kick. All right, it's raining out here, so hoodie up, but let's see how the car looks, you know, getting out while it's raining. You know, that's crazy that it even looks good even in the rain to me. Like, it still have that look. Like, if you just look at it, it still got that look. All right, so not to mention that everybody say big body Benz in their song. You know, that's really, you know, in some of the cars people post, you know, there's no knock to them that say big body Benz, and it don't be no big body Benz, but this actually is, you know, a two-door that's just as long as a four-door sedan S-Class. That's a big body Benz. So that's another reason, you know, it adds to me liking the car. On the startup, I stated it already, but you get the seat belt handed to you. So another great thing is how the car feels. You know, the SLS sits low, the AMG GT feels, you know, a little uncomfortable at times. The S-Class, you know, was tailored to be that car for just what it is. Driving around the city, comfortable. A car that can lower your blood pressure. And I love all them cars. I love the SLS just the same. I love the AMG GT just the same. But it's something for me on the S Coupe that does it for me. Just like why other people get other cars. So that's what I'm trying to break down. So when I really make these videos, I'm not really trying to sell all y'all S Coupe like this is the best car on the market. Heck, if the 8 Series or the Lexus LC or even a C250 is better for you, then that's just what it is. So that's what I be trying to say. We got to stop telling the next person what's best for them. Your car is best for you. So some people be like, you crazy, bro. You like a C-Class better than an E-Class. But if that person is using it for work and that's a compact car that can get in and out of tight parking spaces and things like that, then yes, the C-Class is better than the E-Class. But it really don't matter what's actually better, because what's actually better comes down to the driver. Like I always state, is the car that suits you, is the car that you want. That's the better car. So that's why it's like probably my favorite, best car. And I still like the Bentley GT. I still like the Continental GT. You know, some of the prices went down. I seen like a 13 for like 77, or like a 16 for 77. But the interior don't look nothing like this. But maybe on the newer ones, yeah, a little better. But it still got the old, you know, instrument cluster and everything, the old gauges and everything. But I had to bring everyone this video in the rain just to show y'all, you know, just what I think about the car, what I feel about it, having it for a year and a half now. It's just that much more smooth. It's that much more redefined. It's a car. It is a car you can daily drive, though, as well. That's why some people may say, oh, I'll get the S63 and that'll be my weekend car. And the S550 would be my weekday car. I'm crazy like that. I actually have two coupes. The S550 would be my weekday car. The S63 would be my weekend car. But remember that, subs, though. The S63 is not, S65, they still not made for speed. It's just to get done what you needed to do. You know, it's just so much, like these flowing lines by the door. But it ain't even on my car. It's just how on different S coupes, you can get this wood. You can get, one that looks wood. You can get one without the flowing lines and just the black part. You can get one with carbon fiber in here, all in here. I just like the flowing lines. I just like the way that contrasts with the Designo seats. I just like that look. So that's just me, though. You see, it's 49 degrees. It's still kind of cold out. But, you know, that's just me. So it's so many things to name, from the pillars, windows, to the way it rides, from being a big body Benz. And okay, so I know it's late in the video, y'all might not see this, but why I get the two-door over the four-door is because this look more exotic. It's more a personal car. It screams like, hey, I'm selfish. You know, I got a Camry. I got a four-door that can get around town in. That's not, you know, would be the flossing car, the car to floss in. So that's really why. It's that simple. And the pillarless windows, it's really that simple. Nothing more, nothing less. The exotic and the pillarless windows just do it for me. The way the car looks, the wideness of it being a two-door, it looks exotic. You know, over, let's say, the sedan. So that's why I hope everybody liked the video. You know, signing off, we can't really even see out the windows no more. You know, that's just how much rain is in here. But signing off, Benz, man.